it doesn't have to put something up good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Can we just come to the Lord in prayer and we attitude of worship? Father, you have just one desire, that is to see our Christ and our lives fully offered to you. And that's what we're here, why we are here right now. And so as we listen to your word, we ask that you will speak to us as our loving God. Let this be a time of communion with you, a time of fellowshipping with you. A time when we can just lie down and listen to your word. We ask right now, let it be your presence that will fill this place, even our poor being. And we thank you for this time. We commit our lives in this name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Pwede mo mong pag-ibati mo na yung katabi. Are you blessed? Yes. Tingnan mo ba? Pakitingnan mo ulit yung katabi niyo. Are they blessed? Are they stressed? Pressures and stress are just some of the things that ordinarily confronts us in the modern society. In fact, various products and programs were in the market today to address this growing source of health issues. Napakarami ho natin makikita ngayon. That's why right now, kapag kayo na-stress, you're immediate tendency is to look for somebody who can just give you a sort of relief by massaging you. At gusto natin talagang yung mga masasarap na masahe. We have that Thai massage, Swedish massage, shatsu, Japanese speech, chihuahua, pinagun. Ibang masahe na mga. And right now, again, yoga is getting its strength. I don't know. But it's trying to teach us how we can really be free from this world, forget this world, and flow. I don't know if that happens with you. We have several energy drinks right now that you'll be amazed. Of course, yung ating pambato na ruya, inasupa na rin ngayon, mga aloe vera. Maybe Pobita, Red Bull, Shrike, Meron Samurai, Armalite, Basuka, Granada. Lahat na yata ng energy drinks na pwede. These are just aiming to temporarily prolong the energies that will sustain us and keep us while working. And Christians are not exempted to stress. We face it daily and sometimes it's even overwhelming. And we ask as Christians, where do we get our strength to keep us from going on and serving the Lord? Saan ba nanggagaling yung ating lakas? Ito medyo nanunod pa kayo ng telenovela, tatanong nyo, saan ka humuhugot ng lakas? Yeah. Okay. That's why our topic for this afternoon, is the basis of strength for Christian service. We are still and we're trying to finish this theme for this month about Christian service. And we're going to end up discussing the basis of our strength in our service to the Lord. Saan ba nanggagaling yung ating lakas sa paglilingkod sa Panginoon? That's why, meron pala. Our title is simply, Our Strength to Serve. Our Strength to Serve. And our text is found in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 1 to 6. And I'll be requesting everyone to please Join me as we read this passage and this Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 1 to 6. Okay? Again, we'll do it so that you can be used to this. The people on my left will read the first two verses, then the people on my right will respond until the last two verses will be read by all of us. Okay? Verse 1 and 2, ready? Begin.
Under great pressure, far beyond our ability to endure. so that we despaired even of life. Indeed, in our hearts we felt the sentence of death. For the first time, the believers in Corinth heard from the Apostle Paul the hardship that he had gone through. Ang tawag niya nga po, it's a death sentence para sa kanya. Muntik na siyang mamatay. Hindi madali yung kanyang dinaanan. This was the price of being an apostle of the new covenant. And again, in our book, in our chapter 4, again po, illustrates how hard it is. Verse 8 and 9, it says, we are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. Wala kayong makikita rito, mga kapatid, na maganda na tinutukoy ni Apostol Pablo sa naging kalagayan niya nung siya'y nagbiministeryo at nagbimisyon sa lugar na ito. He was really suffering from terrible hardships and difficulties. Sabi nung he was struck down and yet not destroyed. Kung ituturing po natin sa Apostol Pablo at that time, he might be a boxer, he suffered several knockdowns but never knocked out. Yun po maganda sa kanya. He had received all kinds of trials. And he reflected on this experience and yet he didn't give up. Tinignan po ni Apostol Pablo ito at hindi po siya sumuko. In fact, our passage started, the text that we read, it says in verse 1, we faint not, hindi tayo bumigay. Again, it was repeated in verse 16. We do not lose heart. That's why our text speaks of Paul being sustained in the ministry, not losing his heart, not fainting, and keep on doing what the Lord called him to do. Why? What was the secret of Paul? Again, in that verse 1, he said, because of God's mercy. Okay? Ang sekreto ni Pablo ay una sa lahat ay yung kahabagan ng Diyos. Because of God's mercy, we do not lose heart. We do not faint. Sabi niya, mga kapatid, dito matutuklasan natin, it is not the ability of Paul. It is not his knowledge being an intellectual person. It is not his position that saved him and helped him to continue on in the ministry. But it is the mercy of God. Sabi niya, because of God's mercy, we have this ministry. Ladies and gentlemen, we can only be sustained in the ministry by God's mercy. Paul remembered that the ministry of the new covenant was given to him as a privilege in spite of his past. Bakit niya sinasabing because of God's mercy? Remember, si Apostle Pablo was not an ordinary man when he was called by God. He was one, a persecutor, an executioner. Ang pinapatay niya, ang maalagad ng Diyos, pinahirapan niya simbahan. But along the way, in Acts chapter 9, God dealt with him and confronted him through a light that struck him. Nabulag siya. Kinakailangan ng isang himala upang isang kriminal na katulad ni Pablo ay tawagin ng Diyos at makumbinse na si Kristo ang kanyang kausap. And God did that to him. And Paul is amazed many, many times na maunawaan niya that in spite of what he's doing against the people of God, he was still called by the Lord to be an apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why he realized and it stuck in his mind that it's only the mercy of God that enabled him to continue on. Ang tawag ng Diyos ay dahil lamang sa kanyang kahabagan. Kaya naman, kahit anong hirap ang dinadaanan niya mga kapatid, kahit halos mamatay na siya, ang naiisip niya lang, mabait ang Diyos sa akin, kinahabagan na ako, and I take this as a privilege, that's why I'm still here. Kaya nga hindi ko na kayang patayin si Pablo eh. Because first and foremost, the privilege that was given to him to be an apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ was really out of mercy of God. Dahil lang nabag sa kanyang Diyos. Wala siyang ipagmamalaki. Kaya naman, kahit ano pang hirap, nagpapatuloy siya. He is doing the ministry, he is being sustained because he always read the ministry as a privilege out of the mercy of God upon him. Mga kapatid, walang anumang pride na mag-aari sa isang tao, if we always think that it's only the mercy of God that enabled us to be a part of His kingdom and of His church. Amen po ba?
Amen.
Hindi mo tayo magmamalaki kahit na ano. Hindi ka tinawag ng Diyos dahil maganda lalaki ka, magaling ka, marunong ka. Hindi po. Lahat tayo ay kinapagandang ng Diyos. And whenever Paul is suffering from some difficulty, he will always be remembering the fact that it is only the mercy of God that put him in his position at that particular time. That's why it's a privilege to him, kahit na mamatay na siya, okay lang, because anyway, I'm just once an evil person. In fact, in 1 Timothy chapter 1, verse 13, it says, even though I was once a blasphemer, and a persecutor, and a violent man, I was shown mercy because I acted in ignorance and unbelief. Minsan ako na lapastangan sa Diyos. Minsan ako na nag-usig sa iglesia ng Diyos. I was a violent person, but I was shown mercy. That's why Paul, in spite of all those difficulties, ibigay mo na lahat, Paul will continue doing the ministry because he knew that it's by his mercy that he was placed there, and it is a privilege for him to serve the living God. Ladies and gentlemen, if we'll only realize that each one of us really are here just because of the mercy of God, hindi ho tayo magmamalaki. We'll do our best in everything that we do because we'll treat this as a privilege in serving God. Amen po ba? Privilege lang na binibigay sa atin ng Panginoon, hindi binigay na ipak ng Panginoon sa iba, kundi sa kanya mga anak. Now there's another character in the Bible who was sustained by God's mercy. He's a man who always weeps. Yung tao na lagi umiiyak, iyakin tong tao to, mga kapatid. He always will. Why? Because he'd seen the faith of the nation he's serving. At kapag tinitignan niya, nakikita niya lalong pasama ng pasama yung bansa na kanyang kinabibilangan, ang bayan ng Israel, sapagkat sila'y tumatalikod sa Diyos. In fact, his book, the book that he has written, it reflects the kind of situation, the miserable situation na meron siya as a prophet of God. And he added another book that he has written, that everything in that book, you'll say, everything was negative because everything was evil. And yet in the middle of that book, this guy, by the name of Jeremiah, wrote the heart of the book that reflects what sustained him in spite of those bad things that are happening around him. Okay? Pamilyar po tayo dyan because we always sing this in Lamentations chapter 3, verse 22 and 23, where it says, because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Because of His great love, we are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. Mga kapatid, naisip na po natin, sa kabila ng madalas tayo nagkakasala sa Panginoon, yet God is patient with us. Hindi na ubusan ng pasensya ng Panginoon. Lagi tayong pinapatawad ng Diyos. Siguro nabilang na natin kasalanan natin o hindi na natin kayang bilangin pa. And we realize God has never get tired of forgiving us. Why? Because of His great love and His compassions that never fails. In fact, it says, they are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Jeremiah was sustained. Alam niyo po, hirap ng kalagay ni Jeremiah. There was even a hint from the scholars na dumating sila sa pagkakataon na wala silang makain, even flesh ng tao, kinakain nila dahil naman sa hirap ng buhay. Kaya sino hindi iyak na propeta ng Diyos? Nakikita niyo yung bayan ng Diyos naghihirap ng gusto. Di ba? Taliwasuyan sa mga narinig natin ngayon. No, hindi tayo pababayaan ng Diyos. Ibibigay sa iyo magbuting kalagayan. But if God will allow you to suffer that, who are you to question? By the way, God has a very important plan, a beautiful plan for you. Plan to sustain. Kahit pa na yung kalagayan. Because anyway, God will always remain faithful to us. Amen po ba? Kaya, anuman ang dinadaan ng pagsubok ng Kristiyano, sa kanyang paglilingkod sa Panginoon, it is only be aware that He's given the privilege to serve Him. He will never quit. He will never end the ministry that God has entrusted to Him. There was with this one pastor who happens to be, was able to serve quite some time in a particular church. But out of several years that he had served, he came to a point that he's so depressed, he's quitting, and not just quitting, he thought of even ending his life out of frustration. Alam niyo po, isa sa mga problema ng mga naglilingkod sa Diyos yan, ng mga pastor. Whenever they see that nothing is happening, they will always blame themselves for the non sa mga bagay na hindi nangyayari at walang nangyayari. So this pastor was really serious in his decision, I have to end my life. What he did, he gave some money to his wife and his daughter. Go take some shopping or watch a movie. I'll be busy doing something in our house. He's already planning to end up his life. So, when the mother and the daughter left, okay, this pastor took a big rope and put it on the ceiling. Iguusli na muna yung lubid. When he's about to put the rope on his neck, suddenly there was a knock on the door, calling for his name, Pastor, Pastor! And when he's about to put that, he was stopped and said, who's that? Sister Sally po ito, sabi nung nasa labas. I need your help, Pastor. I'm sorry, sister, I'm so busy. I'm doing lots of things and preparing for this coming Sunday for our church. Just go to our elder. They can attend to you. But the lady outside kept on banging the door and said, Pastor, I need your help. I don't know if I can stay in this situation. I need your help. This may be the last time, Pastor, that you hear from me. And the pastor, and she said, sister, I'm so busy. We have plenty of elders in the church. You can just go to her, to them and let your problem be settled. I'm sorry, I'm really sorry, I'm busy doing something. And this pastor was really trying to find ways to end his life. But then the lady outside said, okay, Pastor, is it okay for you if I just shoot myself at outside of your door? And then the pastor immediately went down from the chair and then opened the door and they talked. Then the lady started opening up the pastor about her problem, and the pastor said, let me take the gun in your hand and let's talk. And while talking, this is not good. You still have hope. The pastor was still encouraging the lady. God can really sustain you. The lady started to cry. And then the lady going back home, again, delivered from the tendency to end up his life, her life. And the pastor realized, I'm more blessed than my sister. And when he realized that the words that he shared to the sister, he realized that he's more favored. Mas maganda pa yung kalagayan niya kaysa sa babae. So why should he end up his life? The situation of the lady also saved the pastor. He realized that he's more favored and more blessed. Sometimes you have to look outside and see that you're more blessed and you're more favored in your situation right now. Amen po ba? Kaya mamisang masarap pumunta sa mga hospital para makita mo yung mga nangihirap at ang mahirap ang kalagayan. When Paul was going through some difficulty, he looked at himself as a person who's really blessed because of the mercy of God and he sustained in the ministry. Where do we get our strength? It is from the mercy of God. Pwede mo mong pakitindan yung katabi mo at pakisabi, God is just merciful to you. God is just merciful to you. The second source of Paul's strength in the ministry is that our strength to serve comes from the conduct of the minister. From the conduct of the minister. When we talk about the minister, those who are serving, the word minister and service came from the same Greek word. Conduct of the ministers. Now let me again give you the situation where Paul was writing his letter. In the church, a group in Corinth actually was questioning the apostleship of the Apostle Paul. Inipersecuted niya si Apostle Pablo, tinatanong yung kanyang pagiging apostol kung totoo ba. Perhaps these people were converted at the time Paul left Corinth. Nung umalis si Pablo, eh baka ito yung mga Kristiyano na nakakilala sa Diyos, hindi na nakilala si Pablo, that's why they're questioning the Apostle Paul. Or maybe these people never knew him really. Or maybe, perhaps, these people were simply who claims to be superior in knowledge or in their giftings that they received from the Lord. Why? Again, 2 Corinthians is a continuation of the 1 Corinthians book. In that book, in 1 Corinthians, as you read it, you'll find that that church was really problematic. Every kinds of problem are in the church. They have immoralities, they have everything, right? And they have people who assume to be superior in knowledge, who have received tremendous gifts from the Lord. That's why the most beautiful passage in love that we always caught, again, by the Apostle Paul, he wrote it to the church that is really in struggle. Yung namuproblema simbahan, sinulatan ni Pablo, ng tungkol sa pag-ibig. Okay? I think this was shared by Brother Bo last time. In 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1 to 3, it says, "If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames, but have not love, I gain nothing." Talk about having everything, but without love, it's nothing. You may have the greatest knowledge, you can fathom all the mysteries, you can surrender your bodies, sacrifice it, burn it for the sake of God, but without love, that is nothing. There have people in the church who are saying, "We have this knowledge, we are superior than yours, than you." But Paul said, even if you have that knowledge, but you're not doing it right because there's no love, then that is nothing. Because these people are again criticizing the Apostle Paul, persecuting him, telling him that we have better knowledge than you. We know the word better than you. We have the gifts of the Spirit. Okay? Ito po yung kalagayan ni Pablo na sinusulat nito. That's why, lagi ko po sinasabi, beware of spiritual superiority. It is still a sin of many Christians today. We call that today as the sins of the Pharisee, being self-righteous and holier than others. Everybody has the tendency to be one. Wala po exempted yan. When we start to be better than others, we compete and we show off what we have better than others, then we commit the same mistake that these people are committing. That's why when Paul was writing this book in 2 Corinthians, he was really tremendously, intensely attacked by these people. Minamalik nila si Pablo. Mas marami kami alam sa inyo. Tinanggap namin yung kaloob ng banal espiritu. It was a bitter attack on the life of the Apostle Paul. You know why? Because when they cannot refute Paul about what he's teaching, he attacked them personally. Okay? He was forced to defend himself. That's why, sabi ng mga scholars, Paul should have not written 2 Corinthians, but for the sake of defending himself, and at the same time, many believers in the church are beginning to waver and be shaken in their countenance with Apostle Paul. Nag-umpisa sila magtanong, "Apostol nga ba si Pablo?" Nagdadamay na sila. Nakakahawa na. Alam niyo naman ng chismis, alam niyo naman ang kwentuhan eh. Ang daling makahawa. Ganun ang nangyayari sa loob ng church. So Paul has to defend himself. In chapter 3, if you're just going to go back one chapter from the passage that we've read in chapter 4, you'll find the Apostle Paul how he defends himself. He said, okay, in chapter 3, verse 1 to 3, "Are we beginning to commend ourselves again? Or do we need, like some people, letters of recommendations to you or from you? You yourselves are our letter, written on our hearts, known and read by everybody. You show that you are a letter from Christ, the result of our ministry, written not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of human hearts. Inaanapan niyo kung ang credential ko kung ba talaga yung apostol, sabi ni Pablo sa kanila. Because you are beginning to question my apostleship. Sabi niya, do I need a recommendation? Am I commending myself? Sabi niya, you yourselves are our letter. Yung buhay niyo mismo ay liham mula sa aming mga puso. Because you are the product of our ministry. They were being rebuked. Nakalimutan nila si Pablo ang nagdala sa kanila sa Panginoon. Wala siyang kailangang katibayan sapagkat sila mismo ang katibayan ni Pablo. Can you imagine yung tense nung situation, mga kapatid? Napaka highly intense nung kalang sitwasyon. That Paul has to deal with them this thing sa ganitong paraan. And so Paul rebuked them by reminding them of his sincere ministry to them, which is evidenced by two things. First, in chapter 4, verse 2, he said, we have renounced secret and shameful ways. Okay? We gain strength by the conduct that we show. How? We forsake shameful ways. Yung mga bagay na nakaiyak, yung mga bagay na hindi bagay sa lingkod ng Diyos, at mga bagay na hindi bagay sa mga tinawag ng Diyos. Paul made the revelation of himself with total transparency, unlike his foes, who subtly hid it, hiding their schemes. Abang yung kanyang mga kaaway are working underground, Paul is revealing himself, free from any scrutiny. Sabi niya, wala akong tinatago sa inyo. You can see and look at my life. I have forsaken any shameful ways. Secondly, paano dinipensa ni Paul ang sarili niya? By faithfully speaking the word of God. He faithfully speaks or teaches the word of God. Sabi na, we do not use deception, nor do we distort the word of God. Hindi ako gumagamit ng pandaraya o hindi ko sinisira ang salita ng Diyos. Because some accuse Paul of using the gospel deceitfully to serve his own ends. Meron nagsasabi sa kanila, yung pangaral ni Pablo, nangangaral siya para kumita siya. Para makahingi siya sa atin ng tulong. Okay? These were the accusation against Paul. But Paul said, no, I do not use deception. I faithfully speak the word of God. This is how Paul set forth the truth plainly that commends himself to every man that's conscious in the sight of God. That's why he has the boldness to ask the believers in the church. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 1, one of the most powerful words that an apostle or servant of God can say is this: imitate me as I imitate Christ. Kaya mo ba sabihin yan sa inyong mga anak? Anak, gayahin mo. Nasabi niyo na po ba sa mga anak niya? Anak, gayahin mo. Paul boldly declared to the believers in Corinth, imitate me as what? I imitate Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, it is not rooted in any form of pride or boastfulness. It is rooted in the awareness of in the importance of living an example which is essential in the communication of God's truth. Alam ni Pablo na hindi sapat na siya'y nagtuturo ng salita ng Diyos. It must be shown through his life. Kailangan makita sa kanya, sa sarili niyang buhay. That's why he can boldly declare, imitate me as I imitate Christ. Madali lang naman sabihin eh, do not imitate me if I do not imitate Christ. May premise eh. He's encouraging them to imitate him as long as he imitates Christ. But those things that are not worthy to be an example, of course, hindi gusto ni Pablo na gayahin siya niyan sa mga bagay niyan. Mga kapatid, pinapakita dito, Paul knew very well. Alam ni Pablo yung halaga na salita ng Diyos ay naipapabuhay. Amen po ba? Alam ni Pablo na dapat yung salita ng Diyos hindi lang sinasabi. Pinapakita rin naman. Buti pa nga ang Nike, simple lang sinabi. Just do it. Di ba? Just do it. Because it is powerful enough to speak about what you believe and to convince people. People may not read the Bible, but they are reading our lives. They may not read the written word, but they are reading the living word. They may not believe what we say, but they cannot deny what we are living and how we are living the word of God. Nakaranas ba kayo that you're sharing your faith and people will not accept it? Pero meron mo ba kayo naranasan that people are starting to believe God because they have seen the change in your life sa mga kamag-anak natin? Di ba? Hindi nyo kailangang mahirapan. Show them your faith through your life and then believe. Kung dati masungit ka at ngayon mabait ka na, kitang-kita nila yan. Pero kung dati masungit ka pa rin ngayon, lalo nilang makikita yan. Christian ba daw yan? Born again ba daw talaga yan? Yung ba? Pag walang pinagbago, you can be the best weapon for witness, but you can also be the best weapon against the truth of God. Christians plays a vital role sa ating sa pagpapahayag ng salita ng Diyos. Again, people may not believe what we say, but they can deny how we live. Hindi yun nila pwedeng pasubalian yung nagbabago sa buhay natin. Mas yun ang hinahanap nila at yun ang tinitingnan nila. Let me give you an example. For quite some time now, 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago, we are seeing nakakatawang sitwasyon uli sa atin sa Pilipinas. Why? Because we are all aware of the new modus operandi, sabi natin system, sa NAIA. Di ba? Right? Ano yung bago ngayon? Kaya kung ikausap ko ako sa Udabi isang bata, ayaw ko muna uwi. Baka kung ano mangyari sa akin. Sabi niya. Why? Because can you imagine series of cases where a bullet is found in the luggage of the OFWs going back to the Philippines? How would we access this job? But the latest is one. Good example. Why? An OFW from Hong Kong was caught. Alam natin yan. Di ba? Nahuli. Tiidad na. And serving in Hong Kong for more than 20 years. Ang sabi ng colonel ng police, I don't know, mga kapatid, kung saan nag-aral yung colonel. No? Sabi, basta nahuli namin sa kanya ito. Even in the court, it will always be questioned the integrity of the person. Yun palang magpapasiyan na. Is there any reason for that person to carry a bullet and destroy his 20 years of work in as an OFW in Hong Kong? You see what happened? Later on, it was found out. Ang mas nakatawa, that lady was caught and her flight is a connecting flight. You know what that means? There was already an investigation. Duman na si Stan doon sa unang flight, sa pinanggalingan. At paano nangyari ito? Nagkaroon ng bala, hindi nakita ng isa. Minsan, hindi mamulong yung mga gumagawa ng kalukuhan eh. Di ba? But what really exposed that? Ano na yung kaong kabila? What rejected that and exposed that? It is the integrity of the person, a simple OFW worker. Mahirap isipin na gagawa ng ganung bagay. Di ba? Kaya pinalaya ka agad eh. Walang kaso muna eh. Sila nakasuhan, tanggal yung dalawang pulis. At marami pa uyan. Why? Because the life of the person will be the one to testify against the accusation. Same thing with the person too. Doesn't need to speak, but against his life, he speaks better and more effectively. There is always, there, we have always a saying, you can never put a good man down. Di ba? Pag wala namang makikita sa'yo, hindi ka pwede ibagsak. So we always watch out for our testimony. Same thing, ladies and gentlemen, because this month is a month where we appreciate our leaders, church leaders, and servant workers. Leadership is also, sabi ni John Maxwell, maraming definition of leadership. But for John Maxwell, this is widely recognized. One word for leadership is influence. Can we say it all together? Influence. When you're a leader, you're influencing somebody. You are an influencer. Lahat po tayo, in a sense, is a leader. Because when you're a parent, you're influencing your child to be closer to the Lord. Kapag ikaw ay teacher, nag-influence siya. Kahit ang trabaho, nag-influence siya pa. So you and I are actually leaders. But again, he recognized. The question in this book is that, where do we best influence other people? Saan natin sila na-influence siya? I gave a seminar on this the first time I came 2 years ago. 3 things. Looks, skills, character. Kapag looks ang tinitingnan, kailangan maging kamukha ka ni Alden. Para ma-influence siya mula ng tao sa mundo. Di ba? Marami bang kamukha ni Alden? Hindi naman yan. Kamukha ni Gil Conrad? Pwede. Okay? Kalahati na lang. Skills. You have to be like Pac-Man, who's good in boxing to influence the world. But only few have that capacity. But all of us has that character that we must develop to be a good leader whom we can influence people through that. We are all leaders in a sense, but character influences the best. Watch out for your character. Look at David. That's why I always hear this, studying leadership. David is my idol when it comes to leadership. You know why? David is a man who suffered tremendously. He had failures, yes, but he was able, again, at the last, in the, even New Testament, he was called the man after God's own heart. Bakit nagpatuloy? David is a man, really, was the heart to obey God, in spite of his failure. And he's a good leader. If you're going to read the book of Chronicles, you'll find that the first 9 chapters are only names. Whose names? Mostly are men of David. Who are the men of David? Gusto niyo po pakilala ko kung sino yung mga tao ni David? 1 Samuel, chapter 22, verse 1 and 2. David left God and escaped to the cave of Adullam. When his brothers and his father's household heard about it, they went down to him, and verse 2, there. All those who were in distress, or in debt, or discontented gathered around him, and he became their leader. About 400 men were with him. Look at the character of the people of David. How he led them. Ano daw yung klase nila? Tatlong biro yan eh. Distress, indebted, and discontented. Distress, mga tao, walang katiwasayan. Parang lagi alibaba, parang lagi natataranta. Ano? Indebted, baon sa utang. Discontented, konting problema lang. May makita lang siyang problema, ang laki ng problema. Will you be the leader of these people? Will you be happy to lead these people? But David did lead them, leader. 400 of them. And yet, when it came to Chronicles, these men were recognized as the greatest men of David. The royal army of David. Kapag may mabigat na laban, these men are the ones being sent. How come? Because David influenced them by his life. He showed them how to be a king. From being a shepherd, he became a great king. That's why he was able to disciple these people who are distressed, indebted, discontented. Pwede mo bang pakitignan yung katabi mo? Kapatid, may pag-asa ka pa talaga. May pag-asa ka pa talaga. Church, We do not choose people. It is God who places people in our church. Regardless of their situation, they may be discontented, in distress, or indebted. It's up to us to lead them. Today, first week of this month, I celebrated my 2 years of being your pastor. Dalawang taon din ako pinagtatsagaan, mga kapatid. I came in last October, first week of October 8th, if I'm, yes, October.